With close to a billion active daily users, Instagram is the world's go-to site for sharing videos and images. As of 2020, Instagram generated an estimated $24 billion in revenue and almost 36.9% of Facebook's revenue. The story of Instagram is the typical startup fairy tale. Two guys with a similar idea get together to form a company. For Instagram, however, 2 years in, the company was already worth $1 billion. Kevin Systrom was born on December 30th, 1983 in Holliston, Massachusetts. His parents were Douglas Systrom and Diane Systrom, both of whom worked in tech companies. Kevin was enrolled at the Middlesex School in Concord, Massachusetts, and while there, he was introduced to computer programming, where he quickly developed an interest. This interest developed further as young Kevin created his own levels while playing Doom 2. While in high school, Kevin got employed at a vinyl record music store in Boston. Kevin attended Stanford University, where he studied management, science, and engineering. At Stanford, Kevin belonged to the Sigma Nu fraternity. An interesting thing happened to Kevin in his third year at Stanford. Mark Zuckerberg had offered him a job at Facebook while the company was still in its initial stages. Kevin declined the offer. Rather, he wanted to spend that year in Florence studying photography. If only he had known that one day he would return to Facebook not as an employee, but as a business partner. For now, however, Kevin was still a university student. Kevin was later chosen among a dozen students to participate in the Mayfield Fellows Program at Stanford. This helped him land a successful internship at Odeo. For Kevin, this was another close one with the tech startup because, as history would have it, Odeo would go on to become Twitter. Kevin graduated from Stanford University in 2006, where he bagged his bachelor's degree in management science and engineering. After his graduation, Kevin joined Google as a product marketer, and he worked on Google Calendar and Google Docs, spreadsheets, among other products. After 3 years, Kevin was dissatisfied. He was frustrated that he was not moved into the associate product manager program, and so he resigned. He then joined NextStop, a travel recommendations agency, and he remained there until it was time to build his next startup. Mike Krieger was born on the 4th of March, 1986 in Sao Paulo, Brazil. He moved to California in 2004 to study symbolic systems at Stanford University. While at Stanford, Mike Krieger was given a class project to work on, a photo sharing project in which he was supposed to build an app for treating seasonal affective disorder named Send Me Some Sunshine. While Mike had no formal training in computer programming, his love for it led him to learn coding anyway. Mike would code at night after work and on the weekends until he became good at it. He soon met Kevin Systrom, and the both of them would go on to become co-founders of Instagram. Kevin soon had an idea for his startup, and his idea was inspired by the success of another networking app named Foursquare. Kevin's idea was a location-based iPhone app that allowed users to check in their locations, earn points for hangouts, and post pictures of those hangouts. Kevin Systrom got to work on his networking app, and a few months later, the app was ready. Being a Kentucky whiskey enthusiast, Systrom named the app Bourbon. Bourbon didn't do as well as Kevin expected, and while he continuously tweaked the app, Kevin monitored how people used and interacted with the app. Kevin Systrom was on a vacation with his girlfriend in Mexico when he was hit by the business idea that would change everything. The couple was talking as they walked along the beach, and Kevin complained to his girlfriend that the company needed something that would help them stand out. According to Kevin, she replied, "Well, I don't want to take photos because my photos don't look good. They're not as good as my friend Greg's." Kevin continues, "I told her that was because Greg used filter apps, so she said, 'Well, you should just probably have filters then.' And that was it." Kevin then decided to make a filter that would be integrated into Bourbon, and this addition caused users to fall in love with the photo sharing side of Bourbon. After getting the idea to add filters to Bourbon, Kevin got to work on the first filter, the X-Pro 2 filter. The filter was good at hiding the inferior qualities of pictures, and soon the filter was complete. Kevin now had a prototype he could pitch, and that's what he did. Bourbon was now past its early stages in development. The app also had several features, including making plans, checking in at locations, and posting pictures, etc. After reviewing their data, Mike and Kevin realized that although Bourbon had many features, its users used the app mostly for its photo sharing features. They decided to cut out all the other features and just focus on photo sharing. Kevin met two venture capital firms at a party, and the firms were Andreessen Horowitz and Baseline Ventures. Kevin pitched the idea to them, and they asked to meet over coffee to discuss the project in more detail. Kevin realized that things were about to get serious fast. After leaving that meeting, Kevin quit his job. He wanted to explore whether he could turn Bourbon into a company. Apparently, he could. 2 weeks after that pitch meeting, Systrom secured $500,000 in seed funding from Andreessen Horowitz and Baseline Ventures. Now that things had become serious, it was time to put together a team. On October 6, 2010, the app's name was changed from Bourbon to Instagram, and Instagram is a mix of instant camera and a telegram. Now that they had the needed funding, Kevin needed to start building a team. That same month, Josh Reidel joined the company as a community manager, while Shane Sweeney joined as an engineer. The first Instagram photo was posted by Mike Krieger on July 6, 2016, followed by Kevin Systrom, who posted a picture of his girlfriend's foot and a dog. On the 6th of October, Instagram launched its iOS app on the App Store. Then something unexpected happened. On launch day, over 250,000 people downloaded the app, causing Instagram servers to crash. And over the next few months, Instagram grew like fire. 2 months after launch, it had 1 million users. 1 year later, it had reached 10 million users, and it was still growing. In February 2011, Instagram raised $7 million in Series A funding from a group of investors that included Jack Dorsey of Twitter, Chris Sacca of Capital Fund, Benchmark Capital, etc. At the time, the company was valued at $20 million. Interestingly, at the time, Instagram's total workforce was small, and the company didn't have even up to 20 employees, although it was valued at $20 million. Instagram continued to enjoy steady success, and it was clear that there was no stopping its progress. About 2 years later, Jack Dorsey of Twitter tried to buy Instagram for $500 million, but Kevin turned it down. Although Kevin and Jack Dorsey were personal friends, Kevin refused to sell Instagram because he wanted to make Instagram too expensive to be bought. Jack Dorsey took the rejection in good faith, and he remained friends with Kevin Systrom and continued to support the company. By April 2012, it had raised another $50 million from venture capitalists at the funding round. The company was valued at $500 million. On the 3rd of April 2012, Instagram launched its Android app, and the app was downloaded over 1 million times that day. Instagram's growth was so outstanding that another tech giant came knocking. On the 9th of April 2012, it was announced that Instagram and Facebook had reached an agreement of the purchase of Instagram. The deal was worth $1 billion, which is $300 million in cash, and the rest in shares of stock. Although there were antitrust concerns, Facebook claimed it was committed to building and growing Instagram independently. In August, both the British Office of Fair Trading and the US Federal Trade Commission allowed the deal to proceed. And with that, the deal was done, and Instagram was officially a part of Facebook. Different sources claimed that the deal could only happen due to the relationship that Mark Zuckerberg and Kevin Systrom had developed while at Stanford. Whatever the case, one thing was for sure. Jack Dorsey of Twitter felt betrayed, and after trying to buy the company a few months earlier, Jack felt that at least Kevin could have called him and tried to negotiate another deal with him, or at least inform him of the sale to Facebook. But for Instagram and Facebook, however, the deal was a win for both parties. For Facebook, it had incorporated one of the biggest rivals, while for Kevin, he remained in charge of the company. He was free to run the company independently. Looking back at the pros of the deal, Systrom said, quote, "We got to pair up with the juggernaut of a company that understands how to grow, understands how to build a business, and has one of, not if the best, management teams in tech, and we got to use them as our resource." For Kevin, Facebook provided the perfect opportunity to turn Instagram into a media company that focused on using images to spread information. This would lead the company to become a leader in video advertisement. After Facebook's acquisition, Instagram began to expand quickly. Systrom continued to add new features to the platform, and it soon expanded its features to include sharing short videos, and Instagram also increased its number of photographic filters to 19. It also recruited former vice president of Yahoo, James Everingham, and Kevin Weil, who was head of product development at Twitter. By 2015, at least 40 billion pictures had been shared on Instagram, and a year later, the platform had more than 500 million active users. 2 years later, Instagram had 600 million active users per month, and surprisingly, its employees were about 450 at the time. 1 year later, Bloomberg reported that Instagram was worth $100 billion. The platform now boasted 500 million active users daily. 2018 was going to be a great year for Instagram until the sad news. On September 24th, 2018, it was announced that Kevin Systrom and Mike Krieger had resigned from their positions at Instagram and would be leaving soon. There were different rumors surrounding their departure, and some news outlets claimed that the duo left because their working relationship with Mark Zuckerberg had broken down. Despite the rumors, the only explanation the both of them gave regarding their resignation was that they had planned on taking some time off to, quote, explore their creativity and curiosity again. Since departing Facebook, both co-founders have kept a low profile, especially on Instagram. However, in 2020, both of them teamed up to launch RT Live as an up-to-date tracker of how quickly COVID-19 was spreading across the United States. There are a few key lessons we can pick up from the life of Kevin and Mike. Firstly, learn to pivot at the right moment. Kevin and Mike cut out most of Bourbon's features and focused on the ones users use the most. And 2 years later, they sold Instagram for $1 billion. Secondly, hard work and sacrifice make dreams come true. Systrom and Krieger spent most of their after-work hours and their free time learning to code. Later on, after their pitch meeting, Kevin quit his job so he could focus on turning Bourbon into a successful business, and today, the rest is history. So, if you've enjoyed this video so far, make sure to hit the like button. Plus, if you want more videos like this about the world's most successful entrepreneurs, then subscribe to the channel so you can never miss a beat.